Yes. 1 a.m. Normally I'd be asleep by now, but here at XCOM, this is a 24/7 job. Hey, Bruce, for the word. Welcome back to XCOM Enemy Unknown. So, something happened last time. Namely, the Overseer got raided, and we met up with some really nasty enemies. But we won. That's what matters most. So we replenished some alloys, which is yay. Definitely major yay. But more importantly, we got a few captures. Let's start with the Sectopod, this tank.
This heavily armored unit is fully mechanized, though we're still not sure if it has an organic component within.
For something so incredible to fight, the Advanced Construction Project is actually giant, giant lame balls. I'm for real. First, you need two Sectopod wrecks, but of course, because we used one up for the thing. What would happen is, it could be repurposed to XCOM to accelerate vehicle and facility construction. At this stage of the game, that just doesn't cut it. Maybe the vehicles. Maybe it cut it down in half. I don't know. But it just doesn't work nearly as well as you would hope. It's just in terms of situation. Meanwhile, we got this ethereal we can interrogate. How you got this thing in here? It's a good thing to know that these things are psionically impenetrable. How do you test that out? I have no idea. Also has forearms. It was struggling towards the end, but look at that. All technology research credit earned. Awesome.
This specimen appears to be at the top of the alien hierarchy, and for good reason. As you've probably seen, its physical form is not suited for combat by any means. However, these elders have an incredible pool of psionic energy at their disposal, which helps to explain why the other species are subordinate to them.
Amen to that. You get the mind shield, and this is useful because it can help shield you from psionic attacks, but also gives you an automatic aim boost of, I think, 30, which is pretty useful if you put on someone who's psionically blessed. But they are kind of costly. Let's go to the Mouton Elite. Weapon tech research credit. But now let's do the autopsy.
As if the standard Mouton hadn't given us enough trouble, the aliens apparently kept several of these elites in waiting for the later stages of their invasion.
A plasma tech credit. Plasma weapon credit. So that's 3 credits for these things. Awesome, huh? Look at this. Everything now can be done in a handful of days. That's awesome. Anyway, let's get heavy plasma because we did capture a Mouton Elite. We should have access to one of these guys already, which is huge. We'll have to do the ethereal device for story purposes. As you see, it only takes 2 days now, thanks to the ethereal helping us out there. That's why those credits are so useful, because man, oh man, do they add up. So what else can we say about this? Well, I think I need to try to buy stuff, if I can. Namely, plasma rifles and plasma sniper rifles, Get 2 of these. I'm probably going to buy one of these. I'm already running out of alloys. Surprise, surprise. Yeah.
Commander, our current satellite uplink facilities
Why not?
Are at full capacity. We should build additional
and let's get one of these guys.
To allow for new satellite.
Oh yeah, because it's a plasma rifle, it has to have this. Of course, the picture there is a Mouton from UFO Defense. And the ugliness that is. Anyway, as you see the mind shield right here. Can you get details on it? Yeah. So, it all does is just strengthen your will. Like I said, pretty good for psionic wielders. Not so much for anybody else. But now we have some more advanced weapons, and I have 777 credits. Not a coincidence. Is that a coincidence? Absolutely. Yeah. Should I? Do I really need more of these things? Of course I do! Alright, all joking aside, we already took care of the major part. Now, because, like the Sector Commander, the Ethereal is going to show up at every UFO afterwards. So, the commanders are out. And we get new things. A supply barge, this is new. And this will come with a retarded amount of alloys and lyrium. As you see, we have Ethereals to deal with. We're going to have Elites, Berserkers, Mutants, Sectoids. Sectoids? Really? At this stage of the game? And Chrysalids. We can pretty much one-shot them now. I think we need to take care of business here. Now, unfortunately, I did get kind of dinged up last time. As you see, I'm out of Sniper. I'm out... both my Heavies. So, yeah, not ideal. However, I'm definitely happy with what I got right now. But let's get better. The plasma of the sniper rifle, base damage of 9 compared to 6. So, El Fantastico. Now, no real reason for me to start stunning things at this point, I don't think. I could switch to the plasma rifle, but honestly... Yeah, one extra damage. I probably can do better with somebody else. Here we go. As a side note, if you ignore these things, what could happen later on is you could face a battleship later on, just immediately after, and it'll try to take out your satellites. So if you ignore it, UFOs and stuff, that's kind of what happens. And battleships are extremely tough even for a Firestorm. Now, of course, battleships also have unique technology that could be really useful to you, but of course you're running the risk. And if you lose the satellite, well, that ain't good. That's money down the tubes and it's panic going up. So, not okay on either end.
This is Big Sky. We're in position near the enemy LZ.
So, barge, huge.
I read you, Big Sky. This was a landing, not a crash. So expect heavy.
Now, they'll probably mostly be inside, but there could be some waiting on the wings. Anyway, there's usually a lot of enemies just hiding in here. Either in the back, over here, or whatever. Then you're going to have an area where it's kind of a long chute, very long hallway, but a lot of nooks and crannies that aliens can hide in. And then you have a little command center in the back. Kind of like a captain's room of sorts. But, whatever, let's run in. Unfortunately, you don't have much cover to start with here. You really don't. I mean, sure you can get to here, and then you have these little lifts that'll take you up, but... It's kind of risky.
Good to go. This looks to be a supply ship of some kind, and the potential storage capacity is enormous. If the aliens are really attempting to bring in this much outside material, it can only mean they're ramping up the scale of the invasion.
Indeed. Either way, we gotta be careful. Very careful. Now, of course, sightlines are also going to be a giant question mark here, just given the nature of how there's so many levels, so much cover and stuff. It's going to be kind of annoying. What is the Ethereal doing here? That is incredible. Absolutely incredible. A lot of this is actually incredible. Normally, you will not see the boss in the immediate area. That to me is exasperating. very exasperating. Now, who knows where the ethereal is going to be at this stage? I sure to think. I'm just happy I got away with it, because that could have been ugly. I can't remember the last time I ever saw this. Normally, you could end up seeing a boss enemy in the first room, but normally that's because you start off landing on the side of a ship. This is definitively the front of the ship. So, what's happening right now is kind of inexplicable. Granted, I'm not in the worst shape.
There's something out there.
Chrysalids! We haven't seen these guys in forever. That's probably the only guys that rushed me this turn. Set aside the fact this feels like a really stupid joke. We can one-shot these guys, which is awesome. So let's one-shot them! I think the reason that thing's more powerful is just simply because of the sound alone. Because it's like, whoom! Like a real whoosh sound. It's about as intimidating as the power bombs from Fusion. Metro Fusion. As far as you are concerned, try to off this guy if you can. You didn't, that's fine. We'll be okay. We'll be fine. Really, it's nothing for me to worry about.
Moving out.
Still kind of shocked about the whole thing. Wow, we are pretty close. Damn. Goodbye. Now, of course, what we're going to do with the Mouton Lee is we're going to have this guy explore for us. We got a friend here. We need to take care of it. Namely, that ethereal. Or have the ethereal take care of it. You know, that works too. After all, the ethereal can destroy this thing with ease. Unfortunately, we don't know where it went. That's a bad thing. Very bad thing. That's not a bad thing, though.
Good to go.
So, this will be interesting to see who or what shows up or where it shows up. I can't even imagine where the jackass could be.
Headed there now.
So there are three exits. This first area, one over here, kind of leads to a little on the wing over here. Same on the other side. If you go through the center here, you end up with this long chute that I was mentioning. So that's kind of how it works. I hear more chrysalids. Alright, the thing that matters most is where this guy is. Where are you, you little jackass? Hey, jackass! Good hit. Well done, buddy. You know, when I take over this place, you can be my lieutenant. That sounds really evil. Never mind, forget I said anything. So, that elite probably dies next turn. Because, as you probably have imagined, the firepower is based off the enemy's will. Mouton elites don't have very good will at all, so it could end up being to their detriment. So because of that, if the enemy hits it with a bolt, it'll probably do like double normal damage or something to that extent, which is not very good, to put it mildly. But, well, let's see what happens. I doubt the ethereal will miss. Matter of fact, I don't want the ethereal to miss. Must be a good excuse to try to go over here if I can. She's not going to be able to see him. No one even knows. What gender are these aliens anyway? Are they like Asari and just have one gender? I have no idea. Why am I worrying about this now? I have no idea. Maybe the political climate seem to be very concerned about assuming gender identities or some shit like that. I don't know. You don't want my opinion of that stuff. You don't. Half the shit my generation does makes me go, what the hell are we doing here? Hadouken! As I said, 17 damage. I reiterate, the bolt will not do 17 damage to you. It will not. Heading to that location. I know that for a fact. Oh, yeah. It doesn't do much damage. Like I said, one damage, but, you know. Still. Sounds really unpleasant, doesn't it? Alright. So it looks like we're gonna have to get right up in this guy's face. So the reflection only really happens if it's considered a miss. So that's a little bit of a misnomer right there. Like that. That was considered a miss. That was considered a bad joke. A game with a very bad joke right there. But whatever. Whatever. Moving. Whatever. God damn it. That was just horrible RNG right there. And I'm not sure if because I did rapid fire, I automatically assumed the second hit was going to do that or not. It's irrelevant. It's irrelevant at the end of the day. Actually, one thing I probably should do is try to get outside. Try to set a position near the top. Because there's a lot of ladders and stuff on the outside, and you can use that to get some height, which will be great news for anybody who's trying to shoot, like your snipers. Alright, let's see how ugly this turns out. 16 damage, I stand corrected. That hurt like hell. How did I survive? I have no idea. Okay. Game. Game. Buddy. Pal. Thing. Jackass. Major League Gas Wipe. This game officially hates me. I forgot, I still have the arc thrower. Is it really behoove me to actually do that? Eh, not really. But if you're wondering, 80% chance. But the way RNG has been, I'm still going to feel really happy right now that I actually got the Titan armor on her. Oh, she would have died otherwise. I sure didn't think how that one turned out. That wasn't a crit either, mind you. Make sure you give me this one game. I'm not in the mood for a lie. As I said, explosion. Modest damage. Still kind of annoying. I'm rolling. Unfortunately, because I had to jump outside like that, I kind of need to climb up over here, which I'm not too happy about. The game's very suspect sightlines are also going to be a major concern for me.
Roger that. Scanning.
Heading there now.
Anyway, like I said, you can usually climb up here. Great for your snipers, not really for anything else though. Because sightlines are so suspect. Enemies technically don't like to hide out up here. They're usually on the ground floor. Almost always. And just as I say that, what's here? Game's making a liar out of me, and a mockery out of me, and telling some really elaborate lies in the process. And I do mean elaborate. Because a lot of the shit that's going on right now doesn't happen ever.
Heading out. Let's rock.
Moving out.
Now, unfortunately, we don't know where that berserker is, so that could be another potential problem waiting to happen. With that said, however, I can also capture, I can mind control a berserker with a pretty okay success rate. Mutant would be 100%, but the berserker would be kind of tricky. Maybe in the 50s, 40s or so. I don't think it would be an easy catch. Yeah, I really don't like this at all. You can see how you can't see anything over here, despite the fact you're in a pretty ideal position to see stuff. This is where things get really dicey, and then all of a sudden it's like, oh, you're technically not in cover.
Roger that.
And the game just fucks you that way. So there's a lot of that goes on. The game just kind of like, eh, kind of throws you the middle finger. Of course, she doesn't have a pistol. She doesn't have a motion scanner. Shit. And this is exactly why, you little fucker. This is exactly why you don't want to rush through the door like that. I am so fucked. I am so. Look at this shit. There shouldn't be that many enemies here. I'm not going to mince words. I am in deep doo-doo.